Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. Let's get more copper. Get this taken care of. Ooh. Actually, this wall, now that I think about it, yeah, all of this can go away. Okay, let's get another smelting area up and running, which is going to require... Let's just get as many electric furnaces as I can muster. Let's finally get our alien technology up and running. Okay. So, can I get by without having this here? Yes. Okay, that's good. So, let's get our blueprint. Look at that, I can squeeze it in. So I'm going to push it back about to here. Can I get two full lines in? Yes, I can. Perfect. And in fact, I don't need these extending out as far as they are. And it looks like I need three more electric furnaces, which I can't make yet, because I need brick, which I am not requesting. For good reason, I don't have the logistics slots for it. Can I get rid of these? I do believe I can. This is the fun part. Of Factorio, when you finally get your robots up and you're getting to the point where in your... Ooh, I have no brick. That's a problem. Oh. Let's see. That is a passive provider chest. Let's change this. And we'll say, okay, connect to the network. And you will... If we have over... There's brick. If we have over, say, 250 brick, then you're allowed to... No. Wrong one. There we go. This one is the one that I want to do. Connect. If you have over 250 brick... There we go. Then you can extract out of this chest. Until then, I want to build a brick. That way I have a constant stock of brick. Two turrets are engaged with enemy. Yeah, they're just attacking me right up here. So let's get these. And can I make... I need a little bit more. I need one more after this. There it is. Okay. It's like I was saying, the fun part of Factorio is when the things that you first laid down are starting to run out and you get to start cleaning up the factory and you can do little optimizations here and there, which are just really nice. Okay. Right, I'm going to want a bunch of... Wait, don't make those. A bunch of red belt. I really need to get that. Get that being made automatically. I'm using way too much of it. Okay, so here's this. Then we want... Let's just get a red belt all the way across to the merge point. Let's merge the other... No, not that merge. Come on. There we go. And fast inserter for our merge point. Okay. Don't need the wood. So, we just need to get copper down here. So, first things first, let's get this completely saturated, and we'll see how we're doing. Maybe what I can do is just link... this half of the of this merge point in. Maybe that'll work. And I think I just saw some copper that I'm not mining. So, let me see. Yeah, right here. Okay. And there. So there's the next line. Let's get some more splitters. Fast splitters, I should say. And why am I not getting any iron? Why am I not getting any iron? Because I was outside the network. That's a good reason why. Bring me stuff. That's good enough. Okay. So now I can... I need more underground... more splitters of that nature. Okay. So let's get these sped up, actually. Let's actually have them pointing in the right direction. There we go. And then I used the wrong color. I'm just doing great today. I'm great, how are you? Okay. So, we are getting... decent amount of... Yeah, it's all going to be on this belt now. Because this other belt is drying up pretty quickly. Okay, that's fine. Actually, what I should do... let's cancel these. Let's get a RoboPort up and running up here. And in the meantime... I want... this to merge over here. I need to go one more over. Okay. This is going to be pretty tight in here when I want to mine the rest of that copper. Actually, you know what? Let's do it this way. Let's bend it one earlier, and then when I come to the south like this, put the splitter there, merge that in, and then just drop that down here. Because I'm thinking take it to the middle because I need to merge it up with the coal, but I don't. I don't have coal. This is obvious. This is not actually mining onto anything. There we go. Okay. RoboPort. Let's get that drop down. Where's the good best spot for that? This is the other nice part when you can actually drop down RoboPorts in a queer area, so you can place the RoboPorts first, then you worry about everything else around it. So that looks like a good place for the RoboPort. And... nope, one back. There we go. We'll give it a light. And I do have... I know I have one in here somewhere. There's the storage chest. Like I said, I always have one storage chest next to them. That way, the robots drop it off, immediately power up. Okay, so this extends our logistics all the way up to there. Perfect. And how far out does our repair go? In actuality, what I want to do now is I want to get these RoboPorts extended all the way across. That way, that entire wall will be under the coverage of the repair bots. Okay. So let's operate that, and in the meantime, we'll also get these. Get another... Why is it so dark? Why are my lights not on? They look like they're on. Oh, my energy's way low. Why is my energy way low? Satisfaction. 40 engines, only 10 megawatts. Ah, I've run out of hot water. That's the problem. So maybe two... Oh, well, yeah, those lasers probably just drained everything out of those engines. And maybe two tanks is not enough. Okay, well, I'm learning. This is all a learning process. So... let's get these placed down. And I need another... let's actually put it there. Oh, look how slow these are. Oof. For the time being, having this merge in here will be fine. Because all of this merging in will feed this area down here, which will back this up, which will feed this area up here. Okay, this power is just always going to be a problem. Don't need these here anymore. Although I do need this here. Let's actually get this like so, and then I can get rid of that. And replace the lamp inside the power. There we go. Okay, so do I have my next RoboPort? Yes, I do. Let's have it go there. And I think these are long enough. Well, it connects from up there. That's fine. And a light. And a storage chest. Three turrets engaged with the enemy over to there. Things are getting damaged. Yeah. The attacks are definitely intensifying on that side. Let's get one more RoboPort. I think one more will do it. And everything will be covered all the way across. There it is. Then we'll shore up our defenses on that one. That one area that's just constantly getting attacked. And this can run over there as well. There we go. Okay, so now everything all the way over here is covered. Logistics and construction. This wall will be defended quite well. Okay. Do I have enough on me to make guns? I need one gun turret. So now, what I'm going to do is get this gun turret in place. I want to say, okay, we have a gun turret here with our... oop, not what I wanted. Pick that up. Gun turret here. And it took it out of my hand. I hate you. Okay, let's get... a second gun turret, because clearly I can't do this with ghost images. You dirty rats. Passive requester chest here. Do I have any solar panels? No, I don't. I need one solar panel. Okay, where's my second gun? Here we go. Okay. You are going to request ammo. We're going to put in yellow ammo for now. And I only want you to request 15. Then I need my solar panel. And I'm going to put the solar panel on the back side, like so. And our medium pole here. Now what I can do is make this another blueprint in our blueprint book. And this is going to be our supplementary defenses. Lasers have a greater range than these guns. But these don't need power to run. They only need ammunition. That's all they need. So, let's accept this. So, the idea of this... And let's actually tear this one apart now. The idea of this one is... Yes, I'm going to... Anywhere I place along here, it's going to be powered, probably, but maybe not. Yeah, see, we're being attacked again there. And the power's just getting... just destroyed. Okay. So, the requester chest doesn't need a lot of power to run. The inserters don't need a lot of power to run. So, what I can do is I can plop this down, and if it happens to connect, hey, I've got a little more power being generated. If it doesn't connect, the solar panel will make this a self-sustaining unit, as long as it's inside the logistic network. This is not going to be used at all outside the logistics network. But, since we're being attacked constantly on this side, what I want to do is I want our wall. I want to extend our wall out, like so. Let's get this taken care of, and we'll punch through here. Yeah, we can get rid of all of this wall now. For the time being. Okay. Then, what I can do, since this extends out far, these are going to engage, this wall over here is still going to be protected. But now, I can take this self-sustaining unit right here. Yeah, it's being attacked over there now. Can I push it all the way out? No, I'll push it here. Now, whenever they attack here, these guns will help anything that gets up close. So you notice how these aliens are getting up that close, and these guns have the range to reach that far. These guns will help without using up power. And now I need to get back to the other side of this. Since this is definitely getting attacked, let's edge it up on this side and then get... they're attacking over here. So let's get one more. And yeah, I'm hooking these into... or I'm trying to hook these into the network for the time being. If only because... there we go. If only because it will be nice... do these... yeah, these all have their requests. Okay. It would be nice if... we have the extra power generation. If I can swing it, great. If not, if I have to put a gun somewhere outside of range of the lasers where I'm doing lower defenses or something of that nature, it will run on its own. Okay, what am I missing? We need requester chests. Which, say it with me now, I really should be making automatically on the bus. But, I mean, look at the stuff that I have. This is just... it's going to take forever. And there's the ammo coming in from the logistics network, and now these guns have got ammo, and they will help out in the defense. And these requester chests will guarantee that these guns will always have ammo to draw from. And later on, what I can do, Right now I'm putting the cheap ammo in here, but later on what I can do is put in the more expensive ammo when that ammo is needed to actually help out with defense. So, let's get back to work on... Do I have any miners? I do not. Let's get these miners taken care of. Alien technology is finished. Good deal. Okay, now I can go to... I want these robots to speed up. So, for the time being, our copper is fine. Let's get the purple science set up. So, you are going to request... Alien science packs, where are they? Or not alien science packs, the alien artifacts. And you're going to request 5. And you are going to make alien science packs. Like so. Actually, you know what I'm going to do here? I'm going to change this. I'm only going to request 5, but I'm going to limit it to 1 stack. And you connect to the logistics network, and you are only allowed to output these if you have more than, let's say, 50 in the network. The reason for that is every single one of these alien artifacts will... produce one alien artifact. Let's get to the actual. There it is. So we need one alien artifact produces 10 science packs. So as you can see, that comes up. It's going to be nice. I think we only need the one to be able to power all of these labs. And of course, it's going to run across. Maybe I should loop this over. I don't feel like it. So, but alien artifacts are used in other things, like, where is it? Under here? Oh, I don't have a research yet, but the fusion reactor, that requires alien artifacts to actually make, and you really need the fusion reactor to be able to use your personal roboports to their full utility. So how are we doing on these? That's good. Those are good. Looks like our copper is backing up. That is very nice to see. We are still getting robots at a nice pace. We're up to 305 construction robots. It looks like we're getting construction robots faster. And right now, I'm not using as many construction robots. So what I'm going to do is I am going to rotate that. This effectively turns off this connection. I want to get more logistics robots in the air, even though I'm not using a ton of them right now. I'm only using 8, but whenever I go running through the network, you see them come out in swarms. And eventually, I really do want to use robots more. So... right, I was all the way over there, and I did not. I don't have the requester space for this. So let's get back over here and grab... I need another 50 medium electric poles, which I am making right here. Those are the medium. Let's grab all 100, in fact. Okay, things are looking a little bit up. We've got full lines on our bus again. We could still do a little bit better on the iron... we do need to replace this out with the electric furnaces. And let's do a quick check of power. Yeah, our power is just... Yeah, it's draining. I don't think two tanks of water is enough. So we might bump this up to 3, actually. Well, no, what I should do is... I've got them on me, and it doesn't take up a lot of space. So yeah, you can hear them slowing down. Maybe we just need to store more water. That's something that I'm going to have to look at tomorrow, or not tomorrow, but my next video, depending on what my release schedule is during this time. But yeah, I'll have to see how much water is actually getting into these tanks during the day. To see... Nope, I didn't need to make another one. There we go. And... there we go. Okay, so we'll have to see how much hot water I'm actually accumulating overnight. Maybe we need to tweak the ratios. We'll figure it out. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Have fun.